The result of the Queensland election is tonight on a knife edge. New polling revealing the race between Stephen Miles and David Crisafulli is tightening, just 24 hours until polls close.
Both leaders making their final pitches across key electorates today to score votes, but the opposition leader is now moving the goalposts on a major campaign promise.
Amid a sea of red on the Sunshine Coast at the 20th walk for Daniel Morcombe, the man who hopes to turn the tide on a decade of Labor government in Queensland.
Good to meet you.
Heralding the beginning of a blue era.
Queenslanders deserve that fresh start for a magnificent state.
The latest news poll figures published in The Australian today peg David Crisafulli as the state's next premier, but indicate the opposition leaders squandered the lead that months ago would have locked in a landslide victory, and tomorrow's outcome now rests on a knife's edge.
We are trying to climb a massive mountain here. We need more than a dozen seats. It's only been done a handful of times.
The party tipped to fall over the line with 52.5% of the two-party preferred vote, earning 13 seats. Should it fail to do so, David Crisafulli's ruling out doing any deals to form a minority government.
I can't be more categoric. The answer is no.
The polls also suggesting the more Queenslanders see of him, the less they like him, slipping behind as preferred premier.
David Crisafulli hammered the regions in the early stages of his campaign, but the final days have been spent mingling with southeast voters as Stephen Miles steadily claws back support here.
The race tightening and the political games growing more comical.
You haven't really ruled out a vote of conscience on the matter.
Absolutely there will be no changes.
This staffer for Labor's Palmerstone MP Ali King quickly called out by LNP advisers posing as an ordinary voter on Bribie Island.
You're a Labor staffer.
Will there be a vote of conscience on the matter?
You're a Labor staffer.
Can you say, will there be a vote of conscience?
Before swiftly exiting in a car sporting party branding.
That'll do me. Yeah. That'll do me.
But the opposition leader is attempting a retreat of his own after promising to resign during Nine's great debate if he can't reduce crime victim numbers.
Queensland has the highest number of victims in the country, 289,657. And you can't cherry pick little bits of figures. It's victim numbers that matter. It's the number of victims. And I'm not giving myself any wriggle room. It's victim numbers. It's not number of unique offences and what happens on a Wednesday and how many young people repeat. It's victim numbers. If there aren't fewer victims, you won't be seeing me.
Tim, so you'll stand down?
Yes.
Today, he tried to give himself wriggle room, saying there could be more victims if the population grows.
Into a household budget.
Specify that earlier.
Madura, I'm not sure anyone would suggest that as population increases, that figures shouldn't be commensurate with that.
So he's chosen a different statistic, and now he's given himself three body lengths of wriggle room.
Abby Geeran, Nine News.
Well, Stephen Miles wanted to hit 36 electorates in 36 hours, and he did it in style.
In his last attempt to reach Queensland voters, the Premier has been on the Gold Coast in a frenzied final day of the campaign.
He's come a long way in 4 weeks, from the shoeless shopper in Mackay to the roaring daredevil on the Broadwater.
Is it your first time on a jet ski?
Not my first time, no, and I do have a licence. So.
After a week spent mostly in the regions, the Premier's last jam-packed day was on the Gold Coast, catching the light rail, checking out supercars at the Gold Coast 500.
There we go.
Tasting Yatla pies. And bringing reinforcements for his housing minister in Gaven. A final campaign announcement of $480,000 to support housing services in Nerang.
I'm very confident Megan will win. For years now, Gold Coasters have looked at Megan's performance up against the plotters that the LNP keep putting forward, all those old blokes.
This has been about preventing the loss of seats in the north and the south to prove he's a leader for both the cities and the regions. Even losing as few as five seats would spell disaster for Labor.
Well, I've been campaigning in Labor-held seats and LNP-held seats and Green-held seats.
The party has been in power for almost 10 years. Stephen Miles at the helm for almost 10 months.
Well, I very much intend to be successful tomorrow, Josh.
In the end, Stephen Miles wants voters to set aside mistakes of Labor's past, trust him with the plans for the future, and not give the opposition or any minor party a look in.
Whenever I stop being Queensland's Premier, I hope that Queenslanders look at my time and see that I didn't waste a minute and that I did my very best to leave the state a better place.
Josh Bavis, Nine News.
Well, let's bring in both leaders now.
Stephen Miles and David Crisafulli joining us live to give their final pitch to voters. First, let's go to Stephen Miles. Premier, why should Queenslanders back Labor for a fourth term?
Well, if you haven't made up your mind yet who you're going to vote for tomorrow, my message is for you. Some people say there isn't a difference between the political parties, but there is a big difference. Labor will always stand for health, education and frontline health workers. We will always stand for a woman's right to choose. If you want to be Premier of our state, then you should earn people's trust. And David Crisafulli can't answer simple questions. He's been vague about some of his plans. He's completely hidden others. Yesterday, we learned that their budget would cut 17,000 public servants. Many of us remember what happened under Campbell Newman, and we can't go back to that. If you elect me as your Premier, I will keep delivering cost of living relief, keep building more houses, expanding our healthcare and working to keep our community safe. I will do what matters for Queensland, for you and your family. Elect me tomorrow.
All right, let's bring in the opposition leader, David Crisafulli now. David Crisafulli, same question. Why should Queenslanders vote for you?
Well, ask yourself, after 10 years of Labor, are things better or worse when it comes to youth crime, health, housing and cost of living? And I know Queenslanders are doing it tough, and that's why we've put forward comprehensive plans to deal with it. And if government changes, if people elect an LNP government, adult crime, adult time and gold standard early intervention will be law by Christmas. You'll have health services when you need them. We'll have respect for your money. Now, all we've seen from the Labor Party is a scare campaign, and you just heard more of that. And I want to offer Queenslanders hope. I want to offer hope over fear. And the choice at this election is between a majority LNP government that's put forward those plans for those big four issues, or a Labor government 14 years in office, propped up by the minor parties. And Queenslanders can't afford that. And I'm urging Queenslanders, if you want change, you've got to vote for it. If you want a fresh start, you've got to vote one, LNP.
Thank you for your time, and Premier Stephen Miles, thank you for your time as well. Well, State Political Editor Tim Avia joins us in the studio now. Tim, it's been a long 4 years. The results will be in tomorrow. What are Queenslanders going to get?
Andrew, Melissa, I've spent the day talking to heavyweights in Labor and the LNP. I can tell you, both sides will be very surprised if the LNP doesn't win tomorrow. And while there will be seats where the results surprise, Labor figures are now thinking about life in opposition. Ultimately, even though Stephen Miles has convincingly won the campaign, it doesn't appear his good 4 weeks can overcome a horror 4 years for the government. And if you need a further sign, the LNP is very confident. Today, David Crisafulli is adding caveats to his key crime victim promise. Today's walkback suggests his focus is now turning to governing. 18 days after he made that promise, when then his sole focus was winning. All of it, though, Andrew, Melissa, is now up to Queenslanders.
All right, thanks, Tim. And we'll have your comprehensive election coverage on Nine tomorrow, kicking off at 5 p.m, bringing you real-time updates alongside our expert panel of political heavyweights. We'll be with you throughout the night until we have a result.